Okay, so welcome to lecture 4 English literature. We'll read The Merchant of Venice today, and we'll read the fourth lecture. So I have this thing in my mind that we'll be reading the fourth chapter, but we're not reading the fourth one, we're reading the third one, because the first lecture that I delivered was about Shakespeare, was an introduction to Shakespeare. Before I make you people, you know, read the third chapter, I believe that I should at least give you a review of the previous lectures that we have, you know, we have had. In the first chapter, we were told that Fawzia has joined us. Let's admit her and then we'll be good to, you know, Muhammad Sheikh Bilad and Fawzia, they have joined us. Let me admit them first and then, you know. Ahad has also joined us. Ramesa has joined us now. Okay, so now let's review. In the first chapter, what we came to know about was that in Venice, there lived a merchant named Antonio, who was very rich and who was very generous at the same time. He was a kind man in her early 30s. He was, you know, a young man. Shiza Faisal has joined us. Let's welcome Shiza. Okay, that was about Antonio. He had a friend named Bassanio. They both of them were Venetians. They were natives of Venice. Bassanio was in love with a rich, intelligent, and beautiful young lady whose name was Portia. But Portia was very rich and Bassanio had no money. Bassanio was a nobleman, but he did not have money because he used to spend more money than he had. Why did he do that? Because he wanted to look rich. And because he had no money and he wanted to, you know, go to Belmont, which was a rich town in Italy. He had to go there because Portia lived there. And to do so, he needed money, obviously, to go and propose Portia because he wanted to buy presents. He wanted to go with servants and, you know, show off a little bit to persuade Portia to marry him. He had no money, so he asked from his best friend Antonio, but unfortunately at that time Antonio didn't have any money either. All his money was in form of ships at sea. They were all gone to trade with foreign countries, and Antonio did not have any money in hand at that time. But because he wanted to genuinely help his best friend, he decided to borrow some money from Shylock, who was a famous money lender in Venice. He was not Venetian, he was Jew by religion. Both Bassanio and Antonio, they were Christians. But Shylock, he was a Jew. He was a money lender. He used to give money on high rate of interest and he was very cruel. That's why people did not like him. Anyway, they went to Shylock and asked for money. But Shylock was reluctant to give him money because he did not like Antonio. But since he was secretly waiting for a chance to harm Antonio, and he thought that this might be his chance to, you know, harm Antonio. So he came up with an idea to, you know, make Antonio signed an agreement in which he wrote that Antonio would have to give a pound of his flesh from any part of his body to Shylock if he was unable to pay his debt. And after signing the agreement, because Antonio was sure that his ships would come back with valuable cargoes, he was very sure about it, so he wasn't reluctant to sign the agreement, and he signed the agreement, took money from Sherlock and gave it to his best friend Bassanio, who took the money and set off for Belmont to, you know, to propose to, you know, Portia. See, you people, please try to admit the class in time, because in the, you know, middle of the explanation, when I keep admitting you people, there came many after the children I mentioned. Uske baad jo itne bache aaye, that it's actually very distracting and it distracts me and I can't focus on the things that I need to tell you people. So please be punctual and, you know, refrain from coming late in the classrooms. Anyway, that was it about the past. Then in the second chapter, we came to know that Bassanio, he reached Belmont and came to know that he had to choose from three boxes that Portia's late father had, you know, got made. He got the late father of Portia, he got three metal boxes made for him. One was of gold, the other was of silver, and the third one was of lead. And he put Portia's picture in one of them because he wanted Portia to choose her husband wisely and choose the best man to be her husband. That's why he came up with this idea. Portia was not actually willing, but just because it was his her father's last wish and her father's command, actually she agreed to, you know, stand by it and choose her husband using this way. And luckily Bassanio, he chose the correct box and they were ready to get married. Yahan tak humne suna tha, they promised each other okay, they will remain faithful to one another. Aur uske baad jo hai, the story ended in the last chapter. Ab kahan se we are starting it? Let's see. Grishano and Nerissa were in the room at the same time and had been watching what was happening. When Bassanio was choosing the box, Grishano and Nerissa, they were there. And they were watching what was happening. Grishano now came forward means aage badhna, and said he hoped Portia and Bassanio would be happy, aur wish kiya unhe ki wo umeed karta hai ki they would live happily and happy. Sorry, Abdullah Mehboob has joined us, let's admit him. And you know, anyway, where had I been? Happy. He said that he and Nerissa would like to be married at the same time. Portia and Bassanio were very pleased and agreed at once. At once means fori taur par, foran. Underline this with your pencils and write the meanings. When I tell you the meanings of difficult words, underline that word and write its meaning above it, on it. Write there, write that. Usi waqt foran aapne wo kaam karna hai, you've got to write the meaning right then. Okay? But then something happened which worried them all a great deal. A great deal is an idiom, it means a lot. Okay? Which worried them a lot. A messenger arrived with a letter for Bassanio from his friend Antonio, who had borrowed money from Sherlock for him. Bassanio's face became pale as he read the letter. It contained very bad news. Achha. Grishano and Nerissa, were there in the room when all of this guessing the box thing was happening. And they were very happy that Bassanio could finally choose the correct box and, you know, became able to marry Portia. And Nerissa and Grishano told Bassanio and Portia that they were willing to marry at the same time as Bassanio and Portia. Bassani and Portia were very happy about their decision and they agreed to this at once, foreign. Lekin uske baad something happened, something really bad happened, which worried them a lot. Kya thi ye? A messenger came with a letter. The letter was from Antonio to whom? To Shylock, sorry, to Bassanio. And Antonio had taken money from Shylock, obviously. They have reminded us of this through this, you know, line. And Bassanio, when he reads the letter, his face became colorless, pale ho gaya, very light in color. Yani ke Urdu mein hum kehte hain rang ud gaya face ka. It contained a very bad news. Usme ek bahut hi buri khabar thi. Is this paragraph clear? Should we move on to the next one? Walaikum assalam, Ramesa and Abdul Rahman. Is this paragraph clear? Yes. Okay. Thank you. Let's move on towards the next one. Portia quickly asked what had happened. Portia ne foreign pucha. Quickly foreign pucha what had happened. And now, for the first time, Bassanio told her about the money that Antonio had given him. He told her too about Antonio's agreement with Shylock. In this letter, Antonio said that his ships had not come back to port. They had been wrecked at sea and all the valuable goods on them had been lost. Antonio had no money to pay back his debt to Shylock, and the date of him to do this, had already passed. He would have to give Shylock a pound of his flesh. I am now certain to die and want to see you, Antonio wrote. Antonio ne apne khat mein kya likha tha? That he is certain to die. He is certain to die means he is sure to die. He is positive to die. Usko yakeen hai is cheez pe. And he wants to see Bassanio. He didn't want Bassanio to come and return the money. He wanted him to just come and meet him because he was his best friend. He wanted to see him for the, you know, final time before dying. That's it. Bassanio read the letter and his face became pale. Portia was worried, so she asked at once what had happened. And Bassanio then told him the reality of the money that he had. He told him that Antonio had given him the money. He told him about the agreement that Antonio had signed to be able to help his best friend. Bassanio told every little thing to Portia. And what did the letter say? The letter said that Antonio's ships had been lost. He thought that they had been destroyed at the sea. They had been wrecked at the sea. And that his valuable goods were all missing. So he was unable to pay any money to Shylock. And Shylock has now demanded his pound of flesh. So agar kisi ki body mein se aap aadha kilo ke kareeb gosht kisi bhi part mein se nikalenge, obviously, this makes it, you know, sure to happen ki wo banda mar jayega. So this was the case with Antonio and he was sure to die. Achha, in the next paragraph, if there is any question that you people want to ask me, keep asking me if there is any. I'll you know, and also give me your attendance. I'll read your questions and it's good that you don't have anything to ask, but if there is anything that you want to ask me, you're welcome to ask me, okay? This window is kind of irritating me now because I'm not really good with this technology thing, but I'm getting better day by day. It's fine. Anyway, so the next paragraph is that the messenger told them that Shylock had gone to the Duke of Venice to ask him to deal with the matter. Ab duke kya hota hai? Ek higher rank ka person hota hai. Shylock jo hai wo uske paas chala gaya hai to, you know, to deal with ka matlab hota hai ke saath, to face something, to, you know, look into the matter, to solve something, to do deal. If you deal with something ka matlab hai aap kisi cheez ko deal kar rahe ho, kisi cheez ko aap samna kar rahe ho kisi cheez ka. Shylock wanted Antonio to pay him his pound of flesh immediately. Foran do ab mujhe, because the due date is over. And so poor Antonio was now in prison waiting for his trial. Poor Antonio here means Bechara Antonio, not the moneyless, penniless Antonio. It means Bechara Antonio, clueless Antonio, is waiting for his trial. Trial is a session of questions and answers in the court. ठीक है, जब जज आपसे आप पूछता है कि आप क्या हुआ क्या नहीं हुआ, when you're, you know, you're facing that thing, your session जो होता है पूरा, that is a trial. When Portia heard this terrible story, she wanted to help in any way she could. किसी भी तरह से वो help कर सकती थी, she wanted to do that. She offered to pay Shylock much more than the 3,000 ducats he was owed. She told Bassanio to go and help his friend as quickly as possible. Ab hua kya ki when she heard about Antonio's situation, she was willing to help him in any way possible. So she was even willing to pay much more money to Shylock to let go of Antonio. Antonio ki jaan chhodne ke liye. और उसने बसानियों से कहा कि तुम वापस चले जाओ और जाकर अपने दोस्त की हेल्प करो. But she insisted. However, is a formal way of saying but. Portia insisted on one thing. They must be married before Bassanio left Belmont. अब पोर्शिया को बस एक चीज थी कि she wanted to get married before Bassanio left. So all four of them, Portia, Bassanio, Nerissa and Graciano, went at once foreign to the church and were married. Bassanio and Graciano then left their wives and went straight back to Venice. और शादी के हो जाने के बाद, after getting married at a church, they immediately left for Venice. ठीक है? Talha has joined us. Sorry. Nerissa and Graciano and Portia were left at Venice and at Belmont, and Graciano and Bassanio, they left for Venice. Portia thought a great deal. A great deal is a lot. Portia thought a lot about the problem. Then she wanted to save Antonio's life because he had been so generous to her husband. Portia is bare mein bahut zyada involved ho chuki thi. Why? Because she considered herself to be, you know, she thought that she owes to Antonio as well. She owes a favor to Antonio. Kyun? Kyunki Antonio had been very, very helpful towards her husband. So, usko laga ke obviously, because he had been, you know, very generous towards my husband, to mera bhi farz banta hai ki main bhi Bassanio, Antonio ki help kar sakun, Bassanio ki wife ki haisiyat se. Bassanio finally she wrote a letter to a cousin of hers who was a well known and clever lawyer. Clever doesn't mean, you know, cunning. Clever means intelligent. Theek hai na? Yahan pe she finally decided to write a letter to her cousin who was a very successful and famous and intelligent lawyer. I wanted him to help, you know, Portia. And what was his name? His name was Dr. Bellario. Ab ek naye character se we have been introduced. Who is that character? That is a famous lawyer, a very successful lawyer, a solicitor, Dr. Bellario, who is Portia's cousin. Theek hai na? She asked him for his advice. She also asked him to lend her some lawyer's clothes. Dr. Bellario immediately sent her the clothes and told her how Antonio would be defended at his trial. Dr. Bellario was actually busy and he could not come, but he gave advice to Portia and told her how to defend Antonio. ठीक है ना, उसने लॉयर के ड्रेस भी मंगवा लिया अपने कजन से, बिकॉज शी एक्चुअली वांटेड टू हेल्प हिम ऑफिशियली एज अ लॉयर. तो उन्होंने हेल्प भी मांग ली अपने कजन से कि मैं कैसे ये सारा काम करूंगी, एंड शी, यू नो, गॉट द यूनिफॉर्म ऑफ लॉयर एज वेल. इज दिस पैराग्राफ क्लियर? शुड वी मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वन? Thank you. So, what happened in the next paragraph is that Portia decided what she would do. She told her friends and servants that she was going away for a few quiet days until her husband returned. Then she told Narissa about her plan. Talha has again joined us. Narissa about her plan. She had decided to go to Venice and she wanted Narissa to go with her. However, but Portia did not want anyone to recognize her when she was there. So she and Narissa dressed themselves up in men's clothes. They set off for Venice looking like two young men. To set off for somewhere, to leave for some place. To set off for, to leave for some place. Ravana hona. Theek hai, to recognize means to identify. And quiet is khamosh. Agar ye T se pehle hota, E se pehle hota, T to iska matlab ho jata bilkul. But this here has an E before T, it means quiet, calm, tranquil. तो पोर्शिया ने ऑलरेडी डिसाइड किया कर लिया था हर प्लान शी वाज क्लियर अबाउट इट बट शी डिड नॉट वांट पीपल टू नो अबाउट इट सो शी टोल्ड हर सर्वेंट्स एंड हर फ्रेंड्स दैट शी वाज गोइंग अवे फॉर यू नो अ ट्रिप अ प्लेजर ट्रिप एंड शी वाज गोइंग अवे बिकॉज शी वांटेड टू बी यू नो रिलैक्स्ड बिकॉज हर हस्बैंड वाज आल्सो अवे एंड शी वुड रिटर्न व्हेन हर हस्बैंड वुड रिटर्न टू बेलमोंट सेकेंडली व्हाट शी डिड वाज दैट शी told Narissa about her plan and told her that she wanted Narissa to help her out. And she told her that she had decided to go to Venice to help Antonio, obviously. And because she did not want anyone to identify her in Venice or throughout her journey, she dressed herself and Narissa in men's clothes. She disguised herself as a man and then she left for Venice. Is this paragraph clear? Should we move on to the next one? Okay. See, they have disguised themselves as men. This thing usually happens in Shakespearean work. Men disguise themselves as women or women disguise themselves as men. And even people disguise themselves as what they're not. In the Macbeth, people, the army, it disguised itself as the woods of Birnam. In King Lear, Edgar, the elder son of Gloucester, he disguised himself as a mad fool. So this thing, it keeps happening. In Romeo and Juliet, Romeo disguised himself and went to Juliet's house party. That was not a housewarming party. That was the party that their father, that Juliet's parents had arranged to look for a husband for Juliet. And this thing, it keeps going on and on in plays of Shakespeare. That is how he works, how he writes. So the next paragraph is that Bassanio and Graciano arrived in Venice where the trial would soon begin. Jahan pe jald hi begin hoga trial. Kiska? Antonio ka. Under the direction of Duke of Venice. Who was the director of the trial? The Duke of Venice. He presided the, this session. Antonio and Sherlock were brought before the Duke. Antonio and Sherlock dono ko leke gaya jaya gaya Duke ke samne. The Duke asked Sherlock to give up his cruel demand. To give up means chhod dena. Theek hai? Jaane dena. His cruel demand, apni zalim demand ko jaane dene ke liye kaha. Sherlock ko Duke ne, and not to take a pound of Antonio's flesh. But Sherlock would not agree. Antonio had made the promise and so he must keep it. Ye kiska dialogue hai? This dialogue has been said by Shylock. He said, then Bassanio offered to pay Shylock twice as much money as he was owed. फिर बसानियो ने क्या किया कि he said कि he would pay 6,000 ducats instead of 3,000 ducats, and Shylock also refused this offer because he was actually willing to harm Antonio. He wasn't, you know, behind his money. He was behind harming Antonio. That was his aim. That was his purpose. Still, Shylock would not let Antonio go. To let go means जाने देना, छोड़ देना. The laws of Venice allow me to demand a pound of Antonio's flesh because he has broken our agreement. I hate Antonio and I would not be persuaded. I would rather have Antonio's flesh than any money I am offered. ये पूरा का पूरा इस dialogue delivered by Shylock. He said that I'm not going to take any money. I'll take Antonio's flesh instead because this is what the agreement says and this is what I'm allowed to do by the laws of Venice. And he also declared here that he hated Antonio and that's why he was going to harm him. He was going to take the take a pound of Antonio's flesh and is not going to, you know, letting him go. He is not going to take any amount of money that he is offered, no matter how huge that is, no matter how, you know, big that amount is. He's not going to take any money. He's just going to take a pound of Antonio's flesh because he hates Antonio and he's not going to be persuaded. Usko manaya nahi ja sakta. Is this clear? Is this paragraph clear? Should we move on to the next one? Please give me your attendance if you haven't given me your attendance yet. Yes, Abdullah Mehboob, how can I help you? Okay, so here comes the last paragraph of this chapter. It says, turning to the Duke, Shylock said, अब ये बात करने के बाद Shylock turned towards the Duke and said, will you permit me to do what I have a right to? क्या तुम मुझे वो करने दोगे जिसका मुझे करने का पूरा पूरा हक है? Or have you no respect for the laws of Venice? और या आपके नजदीक वेनिस के कवानीन की कोई अहमियत ही नहीं है, कोई इज्जत ही नहीं है. He was very, very aggressive at that time. बहुत aggressive था. He could not wait to harm Antonio. Okay, so you know, he was very sorry. I was replying to a child. I'm sorry for that. You know, turning to the Duke, he very aggressively, because he was very angry about it, because, you know, they were delaying the decision. And Antonio wanted to just, you know, straight away go and cut a pound of Antonio's flesh. This shows how cruel he can get. He was very racist. He was very cruel person, an unkind person, a merciless person. He was willing to kill Antonio just because he had uttered a few negative sentences about him publicly. And he was ready to, you know, kill him. That is really cruel of him, no? These are the last 10 minutes. Okay. Please, you know, give me your attendance if you haven't given me your attendance yet. Okay, give me your attendance if you haven't given me your attendance yet. And is this clear? Is today's lecture clear? If there's anything that you people want to ask, please ask me. Okay, everything is clear. It's fine, but you know, I have prepared a questionnaire for you people. I wouldn't be able to give it to you just like that, but you know, why not answer me the questions that I've prepared for you? Where is the play set up? Where is this play, The Merchant of Venice, set up? Kahan pe set up hua hai ye? What country are we talking about? Ye jis play hai, where is it going on? In which country is the story going on? Yes, Zimmel, we are talking about country. Venice is a city. Belmont is a town. Kahan pe hai ye town? It's in Italy, yes. Venice and Belmont both are in Italy. So the play is set up in Italy. And I've already told you that Shakespeare himself had never been to Italy. He used to ask the travelers and he was so inspired that he wanted to use it at this place in his play. Theek hai? The next one is, who has written the play? Who has written the play? Yes, Hamza Madani, correct. Zimmel Kashif, correct. Fatma Abdul Karim, excellent, beta. Beta, you should now, you have to, you know, memorize the spellings of Shakespeare, Shylock, Belmont, Venice, Antonio, Bassanio, Graciano, Nerissa. You have to be, you know, these spellings should be at your fingertips. Next question is, where was Shakespeare born? Where was Shakespeare born? Stratford upon Avon, where is it? Where is it? Yes, it's in England. Okay, Fatma. He was born in England in a town, Stratford upon Avon. Very nice. And when was Shakespeare born? When was Shakespeare born? 23rd April 1564. Where did Portia live? Where did Portia live? Some people say that he was born on 26th April. Some believe that he was born on 23rd April. But you go with the date that is given in your book. Portia lived in Belmont. Excellent, Zimil. Very quick response. Fatma, excellent. And who was Shylock by religion? Who was Shylock by religion? Excellent, Fatma. Excellent, Zimil. Excellent, Bisma. He was a Jew by religion. Excellent. And who was Antonio by profession? Who was Antonio by profession? By religion. But Hamza Madni, I've asked by profession, not by religion. Yes. Profession. He was not moneylender. Antonio was not a moneylender. Antonio was a trader, a merchant. Okay, so the next question is, who was Nerissa? Who was Nerissa? Beta, Duke ek rank hai. Jaise hum kehte hain wazir, ya hum kehte hain mufti, hamare apne ranks hai na, logon ko. Okay, waise hi ye England ke ranks hain, Duke. Yes, Fatma. अच्छा बाकी जो क्वेश्चंस हैं वी विल डू देम लेटर. एक और सवाल ले लेते हैं एंड देन एक सवाल आई विल आस्क यू एंड दैट इज व्हिच बॉक्स कंटेन्ड पिक्चर ऑफ पोर्शिया. उसके बाद आई विल साइन ऑफ द क्लास बिकॉज वी हैव लेस देन अ मिनट लेफ्ट. लेड बॉक्स. यस जमील काशिफ दैट्स करेक्ट. सानिया जावेद दैट्स करेक्ट. मैं इसी तरह से दूसरे क्विज बना लूंगी नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन वी विल हैव क्लास टुगेदर. फॉर द नेक्स्ट टू वीक्स वी वोंट बी हैविंग अ क्लास बट आई विल रियली मिस यू पीपल बिकॉज वी रियली हैड गुड टाइम. इस वक्त तक के लिए तो इट्स अ गुड बाय. प्लीज टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ एंड योर फैमिली एंड योर हेल्थ. कीप वॉशिंग योर हैंड्स एंड डोंट गो आउट. अल्लाह हाफिज. अल्लाह हाफिज.